percentage on it, but there'll be quite a few people in Manchester looking at the game tomorrow, kind of looking at it almost as a mini Manchester derby because their manager is going to be playing against Manchester City. How do you feel about that? And how do you feel going into this game, knowing that in 6 weeks' time, you'll be playing the same team in another context?
É muito por aí.
Well, the contexts are very, very different, as you said. And I'm not thinking about what people think. Tomorrow I will be the coach of Sporting and of Sporting only. From day 11 onwards, I will be the coach of Manchester United. I'm not naive, and I know that people will be drawing conclusions from the outcome of the match tomorrow, but I don't worry about that, truly. The focus now is to win for Sporting, to be coach for Sporting. Regardless of what happens tomorrow, I will be assessed as the coach of Sporting. From the 11th onwards, I will be assessed as the coach of Manchester United. I understand the interest of people in Manchester, but for me, it's more the play, a match of Sporting against one of the best teams in the world.
Hi, Ruben. Pete from the iNewspaper in the UK. With Hugo going to Manchester City at the end of the season, when you were thinking about your future plans, whether now or whether at the end of the season or whether in a few years' time, did it ever come into your thoughts that one day I could be at Manchester City with him?
Obviously.
Well, obviously.
That
has to do... Well, that's something that crosses one's mind, but I never had any doubts. My decision has been made, and that's the club I want to work for. That's the context I want to work in, and there, that's where I want to continue my career as a coach. Of course, that's something that crosses one's mind, that crossed my mind. But when I decided for the club that I want, and I didn't want anything else. So the decision is a decision that I thought about. But I was not undecided about it. I wanted Manchester United, and that's what I did.
Ruben, hello. Do you know what we miss?
What?
Your wonderful English.
Sorry.
Can we have one answer in English for all the people who are going to be watching this game, interested in Manchester City, in Sporting, and in Manchester United? One answer in English.
You'll have time to hear Ruben speaking English. Now it's time for him to speak.
Have Manchester United asked you not to speak in English?
No.
I wondered if you were aware that obviously to win tomorrow night will be brilliant for your current club, but also brilliant for your new club. You could be a hero even before you get on a plane to Manchester. Has that crossed your mind? In English, please.
Sorry, I cannot speak in English now.
Why?
Sorry.
Why?
Sorry. They will miss me in Portuguese, so I have to speak Portuguese.
They've had about 25 minutes in Portuguese.
I know.
We want 10 seconds in English.
We'll proceed in Portuguese. Next week, you can hear him talking English. Okay.
Yes. More basic English.
It's like a cold shoulder to all your English fans.
Sorry. Well,
I don't think about that. My focus, as I said, is in winning the match tomorrow and winning it for Sporting. Then the conclusions that people will draw from this match are not important for me because they could be erroneous. If it's a very negative outcome, the expectations will drop. And I think that's not exactly a poor starting point when I start with Manchester United. If we win tomorrow, people will think that the new Alex Ferguson has arrived. And of course, it will be difficult to live up to that expectation. So regardless of what the conclusions that people will draw tomorrow, I'm not interested in them. What I'm interested in is to win the match, have a good departure from Alvalade, then win in Braga, and after that start a new life in Manchester United. So we could have one situation or the other. It could increase expectations. I don't know what is better for me when I start my new adventure in Manchester. What I want is to leave the Sporting fans and my players happy and to qualify my team for the playoff.
Hi, Ruben. Paul Hurst from the Times.
Paul Hurst, Dual Times.
I was reading an interview with you from a few years ago when you were talking about Jose Mourinho and how much of an impact he's had on your career. I was just wondering, have you spoken to him since you accepted the United job? And obviously you went to United for a week under his instruction at training ground. I just wonder how much of an impact that had on you and whether you think it will help you going forward.
Eu ainda não falei.
I haven't spoken with
José Mourinho sobre isso. Ele também está.
So far, he's very busy with his with
o impacto que teve na minha carreira simplesmente foi eu fiz a pós-graduação que é pensado pela faculdade.
I completed the post-grad course that was designed by him at the faculty. The greatest impact was the way in which he dealt with me. That's the greatest impact he had on my life, on my career. He showed me that
uma pessoa completamente diferente daquilo que
can win everything and be a very different person from what people think, from the public persona. So he was a coach who opened the door for many of us. He was a very important player when he turned up. We knew that his teams would win, and that was something that marked us as Portuguese football fans, because we started feeling, thinking or believing more in our teams. I will have an opportunity in the future with Mourinho about many issues. He's a very experienced person. As regards the week I spent in Manchester, yes, it was very interesting. I spent a week there, an internship, so to speak. A long time ago, I think it was 7 years ago, but it was not decisive in my decision. So maybe the only team where I did a one-week internship, which was Manchester United, well, I'm now going back as the principal coach.